What's going on, everyone? Rabbit here, and finally we have completed our RTM Raptorium test with a 3900X Ryzen CPU. If you are new to the channel or you have seen some of my previous videos and have not yet subscribed, please hit that subscribe button, thumbs up button, as well as bell notification to be notified for future videos. Before we get into the results, I just got to explain to you how I actually did my test so you guys know what you're even looking at. So as we know, Raptorium seems to be one of the most profitable coins to mine with CPUs to date, and I wanted to see exactly how a 3900X does perform on it. So what I did do is I took the Ryzen 3900X and I ran it with a bunch of different settings for 24 hours each setting. I then checked on all the different power consumptions, I checked on all the hash rates and how much we actually mined and everything. Then I put it all into some nice display to finally get the final info for you guys to see how much our hash rates are, if it's worth overclocking these CPUs, if it's not worth it, what the difference between CL14 RAM is and CL16, as well as one stick versus two sticks. Raptorium does use the Ghost Rider algorithm, and if you're unfamiliar with it, it is its main algorithm. It's a whole bunch of mini algorithms within it. So just like Ravencoin is with Kapow, if you throw your GPU on Kapow, you could do it 5-6 different times within a half an hour, and you will get different power consumptions as well as different hash rates each time. It does fluctuate. You will never stay steady on Ravencoin. So the same thing does apply with CPU mining and Raptorium. It constantly switches between them, so I couldn't just throw it on. There's like 9 to 15 mini algorithms within Raptorium. So what I did is every couple hours, I did check my power consumptions on Raptorium while I was mining, and I wrote them all down. I usually got about 6 or 7 different power consumptions as well as hash rates, and I averaged everything out to give you the average power consumption and hash rate per setting per test. So this test did take a couple weeks because each setting I did mine for 24 hours based on all that. So let's get into our results and see how does the 3900X perform on Raptorium and what are your best settings to use. All right, so here's the part everyone does want to see, and that's the results of our testing. In blue, you can see at the top, we're using 167 watts fully tuned. By fully tuned, I mean this is your Ryzen clock tuner plus DRAM calculator, maximizing everything you can for the max amount of hash rate. Again, 167 watts. This is the same settings we used when we pushed over 15,000 hashes on Monero XMR with the Ryzen 9 3900X. Now, everything else in orange is 3.6 gigahertz, which is what I find the best way to run CPUs at 1 volt. And this with DRAM calculator, 2 sticks, CL14 RAM, we are at 112 watts. Next down, we have CL14 stock. That means XMP profile off, and that is 97 watts. Now, CL16 with 2 sticks is 96.5 watts, so a little bit slower, not a little looser timings there. And CL16 with 1 stick of RAM is 84.5 watts. Now, CL14 with 1 stick is at 83 watts. Next up, let's take a look at our actual kilohash. How much or how fast were we mining? What was the performance of these settings? So, first place here, it looks like in blue, we are at 3.29 kilohash, fully maxed out with our tweak settings here. Up next, we're at 2.77 kilohash with our DRAM calculator. So that is 3.6 gigahertz with our DRAM calculator on, maximizing our RAM with 2 sticks. Now here we are at CL14 RAMs, just stock settings, 2.68 kilohash. And CL16 RAM with 2 sticks is 2.37 kilohash. CL14 1 stick is 2.27 kilohash. And our CL16 1 stick is 2.23 kilohash. Okay, and up next is our hash to watt ratio chart. And this is probably the most important chart that you want to follow if you are following this video still. This is the numbers that you do want to look for. So up first, looks like, remember, highest is better here. CL14 stock, that means no XMP profile, no overclocking on the CPU. We're running 3.6 gigahertz at 1 volt and default RAM setting. So CL14 is in first with 27.62 hash to watt ratio. Second is CL14 again with 1 stick at 27.34 hash to watt ratio. Now CL16 1 stick is at 26.39 hash to watt. Our DRAM calculated RAM with CL14 is at 24.73 hash to watt ratio. And our CL16 2 sticks is at 24.55 hash to watt ratio, and there is our maximized performance down below at the very least, overclocking your CPU just like we saw with XMR and other CPU mineable coins. Overclocking your RAM and your CPU drops your hash to watt ratio and efficiency the most at 19.7 hash to watt. So that is the least setting you do want to use. Okay, and here's a chart just to kind of show you how running efficiency is better than running max amount of hash rate, because a lot of people like to argue if you run max amount of hash rate, you'll get more rewards. Yes, you get more coins and whatnot, but you're paying a lot more for power. So let's take for an example a 15 amp 120 volt circuit here, which will give you 1440 watts at 80% rule, which is what you got to run at for 24/7 long-term use, is the 80%. So here we can fit 14 3900X rigs on Raptorium running with a max amount of 1440 watts. Now, if we were to run at maximum capacity, we'd only fit 8 rigs on this exact same circuit for the same amount of power. Based on our previous chart where we could fit X amount of rigs on our same circuit for the same amount of power, running efficiently, you are now getting 37 kilohash compared to 26.32 on 1440 watts. So running efficiently is now making you look a lot more profitable than running inefficiently. Well guys, there you have it. Those are my results mining Raptorium on the Ryzen 3900X. And just like every other CPU mineable coin, it looks like overclocking your CPU is not efficient as well as overclocking your RAM. So I'd say stick with the same way you mine XMR and every other coin out there so far. I still gotta do some tests on various coin and stuff, but I'm pretty sure it will be performing the same. As always, if you haven't yet, please hit that subscribe button, thumbs up button, bell notification button to be notified for future videos, and I'll catch you on the next one. Rabbit out.
Thank you for watching, everyone. If you haven't, please comment, subscribe, and like this video, as well as check out one of these other videos if you have not seen it yet. I do try to stream every Saturday and Sunday, so stay tuned for more future content.